this is where the chick, this is where Dawn runs her haunted house, right? But it's got to have some killer interiors, right? Because you don't know too many people running haunted houses, right? In films, it's ad executives or whatever else the hell they do. This chick, man, is going to be running, working, doing a haunted house off to the side. So you get some really cool interior stuff there. You know what I'm saying? You ever see Manhattan? You ever see The Seventh Seal, where they have these great dialogues with these great backgrounds?
Yeah.
You know, talking about the plague and there's a gargoyle in the back, or talking about life and there's Jupiter or Saturn in the back. I mean, this just looks right. I mean, this is perfect. I mean, the way I see it. And of course, there'll be a whole crowd of people here, so we got to make like a line where people can't go. Have a hell of a lot of assistant directors saying, hey, could you step back like 5 feet?
I was reading an interview of him, and he's going, oh, this is my dream. Since I was a little kid filming in a cemetery, I've dreamt of making a feature film. And I was like, oh my God, you know, this is his whole life, is making this one film. It's like, yeah, I can lose 10 weekends to help him do that.
A synopsis on the story?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to go. The film starts, check it out, beautiful, stunning black and white shot right now at the magic hour as we float past dilapidated duplexes, worn trailer courts, and I've been location scouting them. So when I do this, I've already got what's in between my hands. And right then at that moment, people say, my God, I'm glad I'm sitting here because I'm actually seeing something for once. We get to see Americans and American dreams, and you won't walk away depressed after seeing this, period.
My name is Matthew Weissman, and I'm working on a film entitled Northwestern, and I'm doing casting for the film right now. Do you want to know about the film?
Yeah, I do. 186-minute phone call to California at prime rates? What could you possibly talk to that stupid-ass brother of yours about for that long?
You know he's been having psychological problems lately.
Not on my phone bill, he doesn't.
Take a motherfucking wild guess.
Well, look here. 186-minute phone call to California on prime time? What is that?
They're making a mockery out of my words, man. This whole thing is turning into a theatrical mockery. Do you understand that, Mike?
No.
Well, you will. I'm going to go in there flying, man, and read this fucker like it's supposed to be read, because I've had it.
You stupid fucking bitch! This is 186 fucking minute phone call at goddamn prime time!
I paid the fucking bill!
I'm calling you to let you know that there is a cast meeting tomorrow night.
Looks like there's a lot of work we have to kind of like scrape together, and hopefully everything will collide and we'll make our deadline.
See, I come to the airport all the time when I want to work. There's no phones ringing, there's no people talking to you, and if you're hungry, it's like tough shit. You know, you can't stop and justify your inaction of script writing by making a pizza or something. Man, you got to be in this car. You have no other choice. Why the hell are we here? We're working on Northwestern, the third draft. I've got to get it so it's not embarrassing to give out, you know what I mean? There's some corny dialogue that would make the Pope weep, and I've got to resurrect that, so to speak. I feel so trapped. You know how long we've been living together? Since high school. She dropped out, I graduated. Her dad sold a house, it's almost paid off. Why don't you move out? It's a free country. I don't know. I guess it's just one of those things. Who the hell in their right mind would tell the world, yeah, I'm gonna do this, and then think, man, where am I gonna, I'm broke, man, I gotta get gas tomorrow, and dude's talking about making a feature film, shit.
Now we're gonna talk about high-level negotiations, because for the first time in your life, you're gonna make a profit, man, just like that.
No, you haven't even started at all, hardly. Well, not hard, you did start somewhat, yeah, but not very much.
Bill traditionally is quite close to his money, and it's quite a challenge to pry anything loose from him money-wise. And Mark, on the other hand, has, if anybody, the ability to pry it loose.
I'll show you something, William.
Talk to me.
Wow.
That's
How
right.
How about that? Wow.
She wants to be in your film, Bill.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, we can start then. Tom, why don't you show us what you got, as in the way of breakdown?
My duties on Northwestern are those of the production manager.
Yeah, I've gone over the script on a scene-by-scene basis, and we've got it all broken down, color-coded, broken down. So everything from cast to props to atmosphere stunts.
I think what Mark's idea of a film, of this film, and Tom Beach's idea of a film are just so different. Both of them are knowledgeable filmmakers, but it's a different kind of knowledge. One's more primeval and one's more textbook.
The location type, which would be interior day, night, exterior night, day.
So you got to get a cameraman, you got to get a sound recorder, a boom operator, an assistant cameraman to do the clap like that. And then you want a couple others on the sideline running things
around. As far as where Mark's film stands now, I'm not really too sure. I know that we sort of have had a breakdown in communication lately.
I'll put on the coffee.
I'd like to sleep here all day, but I can't, man. I got to get type up sheets and have them copied for the meeting tonight. Man, I got to get some information across.
But man, there's no excuses, Paul. No one has ever, ever paid admission to see an excuse. No one has ever faced a black screen that says, well, if we had these set of circumstances, we would have shot this scene, so please forgive us and use your imagination. I've been to the movies hundreds of times. That's never occurred. You know, it's like you're the lone man on this, lone captain on this big-ass ocean liner, man, and it's like, goddamn, I need people to cook the food, I need people to run the motors, I need people to make sure that we don't go into the rocks and so forth like that, and oh my God.
And at about 12:30, the realization seriously hit me. No way. I have absolutely no fucking money. I have no hope of getting any money until Covan is finished. Aesthetically, I'm not ready. The script is not ready. The casting hasn't even begun. The locations are scant at best. Are you crazy? That's 11 days away from now.
My first impression of him was, you know, he looks like a pretty raw dog. You know, he's pretty tall and crazy looking. I liked it.